Hi there. With the crisis in Venezuela, things are unfolding so fast and so horrifically that I'm even doing this video in informal attire just to see if anyone is even listening, to help them try and get a grip on what the heck is going on, right? And what I learned today is that, first of all, I don't even like mentioning this, but I, for me, the most important thing is to find out, are there nuclear missiles on the ground in Venezuela? And that's gonna be my greatest goal today, is to try and get information on that. However, before that's even possible, I saw a new theory on why I'm getting information that Russia is now planning, maybe even signed some kind of a treaty to establish permanent military bases in Venezuela. So this is like a total freakout. And we know that, I think, you know the expression in military, know thine enemy? So that's really, at this point, obviously, Russia and Mr. Maduro are our enemy, and we need to know them. And I think there may be more behind us as to who the enemy is, but in any event, Paul Craig Roberts is a former Reagan administration, I think, Treasury official who is a public commentator, lives in Georgia, and he is theorizing, in fact, he's even quoting, I believe, Russia as saying that what it's doing in Venezuela is really about the Trump administration's threats to cancel the intermediate nuclear missile treaty that was negotiated by President Reagan with Mikhail Gorbachev back in the 1980s. And of course, this is a very important treaty, and I personally think this is the best explanation that fits the facts. Russia is expanding militarily worldwide, I believe, at this point, from the information I'm getting. So this is not just Venezuela. It's a total aberration from their previous conduct, but it coincides with the deadline, which I believe was this threat. Are we aware, the United States, from what I understand, has a military budget that exceeds the next 20 countries, including Russia, combined. So if you take the top 21 countries in the world with defense budgets, our U.S. military budget is greater than all of the defense budgets of all of the next 20 countries, including Russia, combined. If you add Britain, France, all of them, all the nuclear powers, Russia, and so on, you know, India, Pakistan, add them all together, ours is greater than all 20 combined. So the idea that we have reason to be accusing Russia of violating arms agreements doesn't really ring true to me. What does ring true, and I think to Paul Craig Roberts, is that the same neocon, New World Order, Iraq War 2003 people, including John Bolton, are trying to manufacture a pretext. They're really trying to take us to war with Russia, but they're trying to make it look like it's Russia's fault. And then, it's not that I have any love for Russia. I don't know about you, but my stomach, I will never be the same after seeing Vladimir Putin high-five Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman at the recent G20 meeting. Did you see that little clip where he comes in? Mohammed bin Salman is accused of the chainsaw murder of journalist Jamal Khashoggi chainsaw murder, right? They pretty much have proof. CIA has concluded that this is what happened. He ordered the murder and oversaw it. And then Vladimir Putin comes in and high-fives him in front of the entire world. And it's now 2 or 3 weeks later, and he still hasn't apologized or explained or whatever, you know. I don't know about you, but that like just totally hardens me as to what kind of person this is. I mean, I could go on, but anyway, so nonetheless, if one tries to know thine enemy, which is a big expression in World War II, know thine enemy, then you go back, what could explain Russia's departure from decades? The Venezuelan government's been in power since 1998. Russia has not been actively involved. I mean, apparently they've been involved, but not like this. So I think it's no coincidence that this is the time when the deadline has been set by neocons within the Trump administration. I don't even lay this off on Trump. He's got this immoral, in my opinion, Mueller investigation bearing down on him, jailing his friends. I think Mr. Mueller is a cause of this, if we get right down to it. So he's letting the neocons run amok in his administration, and they're trying to push a war with Russia, trying to encircle Russia, look at the Ukraine provocation, trying to bust their budget with this INF false allegations, false threat to cancel that treaty. It was negotiated by Ronald Reagan, right? And so who knows, you know, it's all a big mystery, but we're all trying to put the puzzle together. And so that's my latest. We don't know. I don't know. But that's my guess. As of today.